Hello everyone, today we're going to be doing something extra special. I am super excited about it. I have been given an exclusive first look at Rachel from Woodburn Corner, her new pyrography book. It is a how-to book. I'm really excited for her. She's got some stunning pyrography work herself, but she also is a huge component of community over competition in the Woodburn community, and she helps. She has a burn club that you can join. She also is now launching just this past weekend a burn club plus on Patreon. She also does weekly and monthly topics that you can jump on and use as inspiration and share, and then she shares some of her favorites on her Instagram. So she's a huge component in the wood burning community of fostering this community of artists. I am all about that. I love that, and so I'm really excited to be able to promote her book today. And we're going to be doing this DIY from the book. I'm following her tutorial exactly. I was going to try to do my own thing, but her tutorial was so simple and so beautiful that I really wanted to do it justice and do exactly as she said. So let's jump right into that, and I'll cover how you can get your copy of the book at the end of this video. So I had never even thought to burn on canvas before, so when I first jumped into this project, I got way too excited and I started burning without even showing the canvas bag that I chose first. So that's why you'll see this single line on here. I purchased this small little canvas bag with a zipper pocket and a long string handle. It reminded me of a larger sized passport case, but I'm actually going to use it to store my pens and pencils for when I'm on the road. So I really liked it, and considering I got it from Hobby Lobby for only $1.99, it is pretty decent quality. I'm actually pretty surprised. So overall, this project is very easy. It's the perfect beginner project if you're interested in trying to burn on canvas. If you end up purchasing the burn book, it's on page 62 of the book. And in her book, she uses a canvas backpack. So I'm doing a smaller sized bag than she did, but I'm following her pattern pretty much to a T. She does warn in her book that canvas can be toxic to work on, so do wear your protective gear, which is listed in her materials of the book. But I just use a regular face cover mask that I've been using for COVID purposes. And it's not perfect because it doesn't have a high grade air filter in it, but that's what I use. And I also have a fan that blows fumes away from my face. And I work with open windows. The first step that I did skip was to use a water-soluble pen to draw on the design. As you guys know, I'm pretty confident with my line work and my burnings for most things, so, and especially for this design, I didn't feel like I needed to use a pen, but if you want to do that, go ahead and do that. You're going to play around with the direction and spacing of your lines here, and just have some fun with it. Try to create some variety. You don't want it to look totally uniform. You want it to look naturally uneven and imperfect. So for the lines, I am using a razor tip medium spear pen. Rachel recommends either a spade or a writing nib as well, but the razor tip medium spear pen is my favorite tool for drawing nice clean lines. And as Rachel mentions in her book, I did start at a very low setting and gradually increased it, and you'll see that I'm going very slow and sometimes it's not even burning because the setting was too low. So I gradually increased it until I was more confident in the burning of the canvas. But since this is my first time doing this, I was super nervous about it. So I started at a 3 on my Colewood machine, and I bumped it up to about a 6 by the end of this video. For the little seeds, little balls on the end of the branches, I switched out my pen to an interchangeable pen that I bought on Amazon, and I have a bunch of interchangeable nibs, but one of them is a ball nib that I purchased from a local woodworking store. I have a variety of ball nibs of different sizes, but I prefer to work with the tiny one like this. It was a little bit more expensive because it's kind of hard to find, but it gives you a nice small dot that you can increase the size, and it gives you a little bit more control than some of the bigger ball nibs. And then I am just like that, I'm all done.
But Rachel does mention if you used a water-soluble pen to draw on your design, then you can just use a wet sponge to clean off your marker pen marks off of the bag, or if it's machine washable, you can throw it in the machine wash. Since I skipped that step, I didn't have to do that, and now it's all finished.
All right, so that is the finished project. I hope that you found this tutorial helpful. Please do check out Rachel's book. I've linked it in the description box below. I've also linked her website and her new Burn Club Plus Patreon in the description box below. If you are interested in wood burning and you're interested in being part of a community of artists, I really recommend this group of artists and Rachel, the Woodburn Corner, because it has been so helpful for me. And I absolutely love when groups can come together and artists can come together and support each other and lift each other up. And it isn't about competition. It isn't about who can do what first or better. It's just about helping each other and really improving your craft. And when you can find a community like that, you really need to stick with it because they're hard to find. So again, the link is in the description box below if you want to pre-order her book on Amazon. It does become available, I believe it is August 18th. So you can pre-order it now, or if it's after August 18th when you're watching this, you can go ahead and buy it. And please do, if you do buy it, leave her a review. As with comments and likes on this video, just like that, reviews on Amazon really do help products to get featured and to get more eyes on that product. So those are all free things that you can do to help artists out and help each other grow. If you end up buying the book and doing a project from it, please feel free to tag me and let me know that I was the one that sent you there. I will share it on my Instagram stories and maybe even mention it on my community tab here on my YouTube channel. So please do let me know that you tried it out. I want to see what you guys can come up with. Thanks so much for watching, and until next time, remember to create, love, and travel on. Bye!